Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. This is a pretty awesome, it's a Sonic, just a Sonic, okay? Oh my god, that's loud! Didn't even realize how loud that was. Anyway, my computer's overheating. Yeah, it's Sonic. Sonic 2, guys. Real Sonic 2. The real one. Okay? Trust me. I wouldn't know I made it. Wait, no. No, really. I made this, Sonic engine. This is obviously not Sonic 2. It's got a couple bugs. That I've gotta flush out and fix and debug and all the boring stuff. But, it's an engine. And it's the easiest one to use by far that I've found. At least using myself. As you can see, I've made an entire level with it. It's a small one, but it's a level. Look, I don't know about you, but this is one of the biggest undertakings I've ever made, okay? Genuinely, I went from, like, a time start project. If I, show you that in a bit, I'll show you a little beta of it, like a 2-minute video. But here we got a couple, like a beta or two, to show you of this engine. At the moment, the engine is at version 0.2. It's the second revision. Yeah, I just wanna show you something. So at the moment, we have pretty basic physics. You can walk up these. Can dash, which I didn't know from last episode, as you can see. It's not nearly as OP, you can't spam it. Like crazy, at least. You can't spam it like you're playing Adventure or something. No, you are not Adventure Sonic, you are Sonic 2, Sonic. And he's only just learned how to dash, so. Yeah. It's his first time, okay? Just leave him alone. He ain't doing nothing. Yeah, we had springs, which is pretty sick. Favorite part of this update. Genuinely. That's pretty embarrassing. Yeah. Springs are, in fact, my favorite part of this update, believe it or not. I know it sounds a bit crazy for me to say that, but yeah, it is. It's really good. I haven't shown anyone else this big project. Except for you, my dear viewer. If you want, you can subscribe. More like this. Yeah, I will be uploading more of this more often, don't worry. This is just episode 2, but of course it is. I swear to god, none of my series get past episode 2, and if this doesn't, well, don't say I didn't expect it. And in fact, don't say you didn't expect it, because you definitely did, okay? Also, yeah, there's a little bug that I want to tell you about. So basically, if you roll, hold on, let's go to like a flat empty space. So if you roll this way, and just hold down the entire way, then you'll be looking this way. And obviously you're not actually looking this way. You aren't. Yeah, if you just look, you're looking this way, but you're actually not, because you're actually looking this way for some reason. You went left instead of right? Obviously it fixes once you've done the spin dash, just a visual glitch, but still want to fix that at some point. Not now. Too late. I'm gonna go to bed, in fact. But, yeah. I made some of the level geometry in, Illustrator, because it was the easiest way to do it, like this curve. I edited it a little bit before I imported it. I didn't just buy Illustrator for this, don't worry. I'm not a psychopath, I actually have to do it for my classes. Yeah, I have some Illustrator classes. Because I'm an artist, if you guys remember. Yeah, I'm gonna probably make some original Sonic sprites for this, but right now I really can't be bothered. You guys are lucky that we even have Sonic 2 sprites in here. I would have probably just been really lazy and made it a square if I made this any later than, like, I don't know, 9 p.m. Obviously, this isn't, you know, Genesis accurate now, at least. It was before, but not now. I kind of just did that to make life easier on myself and to just fix the physics a little bit. Obviously, the physics in the Genesis games are good. Not perfect, obviously, but better than mine. My implementation is a bit shoddy, but you know, it's better than other Sonic engines on Scratch. If such Sonic the First Resort is, it's questionable. I don't really even call it a Sonic engine. It's just a side scroller, very, very, very basic one. Okay. Obviously, I couldn't really say this is Scratch. This is actually Turbo Warp. Don't tell anyone about that. Don't, please, don't tell anyone I said that. Okay. Else I'll get arrested. Right. Also, yes. You can actually roll backwards, which is pretty sick. I really like that. You can roll backwards, even though it doesn't actually show you're rolling backwards. Yeah, look. Yeah, it's weird. Anyway, spring works. I like the spring. My favorite part. Yeah, I'm gonna add yellow springs. That one's still a work in progress for some reason. I don't know why it's still a work in progress. I've been working on it for the past 2 hours. It's because the freaking, the way I made the red spring code for some reason. I don't know why I made it so shoddy. I made it quite late, so it's earlier than when I made the red spring code. I was really, really tired when I made the red spring code, so it's kind of horribly made. You can see the camera kind of jitters a little bit. In fact, no, it jitters a lot. In person, it jitters even more than on camera. I would know because everything is being recorded right here is what you see. Yes, even the lag, it's quite laggy. Yeah. Yeah, even the lag from the beginning of the video was from this. I'm not joking, this is why I say to build things that are better than what I have. Yeah, the things I have now are kind of poopy, so, yeah. Obviously this will be put on a website for you guys to download, or like Google Drive or maybe Dropbox, but I'm kind of stupid, so who knows. So, yeah, in fact, if you guys want to see the end of the, of course you know. Yeah. It's just a, flat line, doesn't go on forever. Don't want to make the level too big, but it will make it a little bigger at some point. 100%. I'll probably have two acts. Like right here, it's kind of like a puzzle segment. As you can see, you can't jump up or anything because that would be too easy. Here you have to actually like dash up and stuff. You actually have to use this like little bump in the road. And one thing I've noticed is that this is kind of like geometric, but it's also not, because if you look at this curve. Just, you know. Obviously, let me show you how to curve at the start of the level. I'm sure you've already seen this, but yeah. Also, you can't run up walls yet. I mean, I probably won't ever add that, actually. I mean, don't know why I'm saying yet. But yeah, this other curve up here, that's definitely not geometric, that's quite mathematical. Because sine waves. Yeah, like I said, I made a lot of stuff in Illustrator, like this, and it was kind of imported weirdly into Turbo Warp. I don't know why I had to edit it a ton to make it look even, you know, playable. In fact, this entire section was a whole lot bigger at some point, like the steps, you actually had to like these four steps were like, used to be the size of one step. Like, Sonic was absolutely tiny in comparison to the, level. Like, you actually had to, like, jump up, like, four times, you know, to get up to second level. Like, here, you would be walking for, like, 5 minutes, and you finally get to this ramp. And it wouldn't work, because it was way too big to work. Also, I haven't added the code yet. So that's why it doesn't work. Also, I'm using the wrong button. Probably mention that can in fact use AS, can use AND to move. You cannot use it to crouch, however, because I haven't added that. Don't know personally, I just use the arrow keys to play this game. I'm not changing the keybinds at all. I don't really want to. I never will want to. No changing keybinds here. Screw you people who don't like playing with ZNX. I don't like you. Look, I don't know about you, but my A, B, and C buttons are Z, X, and C in on my keyboard. So, this kind of just feels regular for me. Now, my pause button is enter, which is why I'm going to set it to enter. Pause button's going to be enter instead of escape, because escape is the out full screen, and I don't want that. So we're going to change it. Look, escape, look. Look what escape does, look. Lag. Yeah, escape does that for some reason. That took a while. Boing. In fact, I want to show you something really funny. If you go to 50% scale, you can see all of the level. Look at that. It's laggy as hell, but you can see it all. Yeah, also, if you press the hashtag button. Yes, the hashtag button. It'll kind of zoom in to the perfect size. It's not really the perfect size, because I don't really like playing at 350. I like playing at 300, because it feels just too big at the size. So I play at a safe 300. Not too much smaller. Just more comfortable to look at. Ooh, bounce. Sometimes he bounces off the walls, which I really like. It's very rare, but when he does, I like it. It's like when you hit a corner, like that. Like when you hit a corner, sometimes it'll do that. I'm not sure why, but I like it. So like how, that's not how gravity works, Sonic. Look, he's just like leaning over the edge. Look at the helmet. Also, I know these aren't the correct sound effects, I'm not dumb, but like, I kind of didn't have the time or the patience to sift through the entire sound test just to find the sunk revving up sound. I'm sorry, I just don't have the time to do that. I apologize for any mistakes I make. Like, it's just the sound, bro. You know, because like, the rolling sound is easy enough to find, and the jumping sound is easy enough to find. You know, and you know, the skating sound is easy enough to find on YouTube and stuff. But nothing else is. Anyway, I'm probably gonna leave. Enjoyed, you know, like, subscribe, hit the bell, you know, comment, etc. Blah, 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 blah. I'll see you in the next one. This has been Windows 10 Pro, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.